understand why we lift our hands and sing praises. And people can't comprehend that when we dance, we're not crazy. See, maybe they don't realize that sitting high is the Father. And this is what
I'm satisfied. Just see you everywhere. When you are done, sweet Jesus, carry your glory.
your houses. In 2018, I know you've created a whole lot of things you want God to do through you. But I've come to tell you that there is more to writing. After writing all you need done, then you need an injection. It's in this kind of meeting you get injected. A whole lot of people, a whole lot of you have already received the injection before anybody prays for you. I walked into our work yesterday, it's already another day. I walked into our work yesterday as a helpless man. You might not understand. I walked into the city yesterday as a helpless man. I entered where they kept us as a helpless person. Somebody who has nothing to offer. And I sat down. People who could hear me praying before I came here. All I was saying was, God, please invade all my plans. All I have planned to do. All I have planned to do. My ministrations this year, invade them. I don't want to do anything in a normal way. Let everything be abnormal. For a spiritual man is like a madman. Until that madness is seen, you are not yet given God complete charge over your life. If you are the one who tells God when you pray, when you study, and you always keep to it at all times, sometimes when you wake up in the morning, tell him, Lord, I know I have my timetable, but I love it more when you invade me. Has he invaded you in the marketplace? Has he happened to you that in the midst of people, they are having a conversation, they are shouting, making noise, and you are just there with them, teardrops are rolling down your face?
Tomorrow.
So when you're saying, I have come to draw, some of you, you just sing this song because you know it. If I go for any ministration, I must sing this song. That's because God told me, I have stayed before you, waters. Go and push men into it. With somebody that always push you into sin. Please, I beg you in the name of our Father. The person I'm talking to, I won't call you out because I can call your name. But then I won't call you out. Please, tell the person you don't want again. You've been delaying God. There are things he wants to do with you. You've been delaying him. Break it up. Do what? Can we scream it out together and break it up?
When you don't know Do you have desire?
also responded. Do you understand? They personalize it. Don't say we, say I. I have come to draw. I don't know if you understand. Now, I want you, I will give you 3 minutes to do it. I pray for you, and then I drop the microphone. We're going to sing it. I have come to draw. Now, sing. It's a personal thing. It's a personal thing. Play for them. Play for them. Play for them. Just sing like that. Sing like that. Sing, sing, sing.
The one.
is our comforter. He's our helper. Are you listening? He's our helper. So as your hands are lifted up, the one who helps will help you. You can't be that successful without the Holy Ghost. You can have money, but money is not fulfillment. God created man, gave him wisdom, gave him money, gave him understanding, but then he removed fulfillment from man and placed it upon himself. So for any man to be fulfilled, you must be constantly connected to him. That's why the moment you run away from him or you start doing a whole lot of things, you don't have time for God, you notice like you feel like you are dying from inside. Because fulfillment is only in God. Go and ask that hotel. He will tell you that there is still something his heart tells him he needs. Even in the midst of all the money. So you have it, and now some of you are about to get it now. So I pray for you. As many of you that you have ministries here, come down. I will come down when the time comes. Do you understand what I'm saying? Listen to me. I'm easily distracted. That was why I said you should go down. So I avoid it a lot. So listen, every ministry here, every academic problem, anywhere you need the Holy Spirit in your life to help you, I pray for you. Some of you, your family needs a light. The light of the Lord shall shine upon your family. For Jesus is the poverty killer. Whatever has stopped, there's somebody. The reason you didn't enter into the university, even when you got admission, is because there was no money to pay for you. But right now, that embargo is broken. It's broken. Now I call the name of Jesus, who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all we could ever ask or imagine. And he will do whatever you desire. Whatever you desire, he will do it. He will do it. He will do it. He had done it. He did them all at the cross of Calvary. So we withdraw from the bank. We withdraw from the bank. I call the name of Jesus three times, and then you just play. Then I leave you. All eyes closed if you're here with me. Jesus, 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 I send you all out to the Holy Ghost, and I say, let everything that needs to be amended be amended. Whatever that needs to be built. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, and in the name of God the Holy Ghost, wherever you are, receive fire. Where God is known, I know. Fire. Let it go.
Church, I was the person who cut her hair and set her free, gave her new clothes. So many of you, when you
He has raised a cripple when we are worshiping. But then there is more to God. There is more to God. I told you the other time that somebody, his hand will cut his skin. He will use your hand to cover it without any medication. There are realms. And so we push you into that realm. Wherever you are here, I pray for you that from today, when next you open up your mouth to speak of Jesus, He will glorify Himself in you. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now as you walk back to your seat, you're going to sing this song.
Our hands and sing praise.